Hey guys, yeah, it's about 10:48. I've got about a little over 70 minutes before I clock in, so I figured why not do something that I do a lot, and that is topics on my mind, but on location for my job before I clock in. Now, apparently, you won't be seeing this until at least tomorrow, at the very least, because I already have, as you can tell, some videos already lined up for you. The last one, of course, will not be monetized because that's just a 4K up conversion of the anniversary brawl from That Guy with Glasses, Channel Awesome, if you will. So that's the only one that will not be monetized. But by the time I'm recording this, there is the second one that I uploaded for today, coming up, and then one after that as well. And then the anniversary brawl, and we'll go from there. And I do have one, if not already, pretty much done and in the can, probably already finalized and produced through Cyber Power Director. And that is, of course, my review of Tales from the Territory, the fourth episode on Championship Wrestling for Florida. So you'll be able to check that out tomorrow as well. But with that said, we've got a couple of topics we're going to talk about here. Some that, you know, have been, some that are newsworthy that have come out that I think a lot of people will be interested in, and some that basically, if you live here in the state of California, do concern you. So with that said, first of all, let's take a look care of a little business. As a person I subscribe to here on YouTube would say, let's pay some bills. And before anything, if you want to support me, like the video, you know, hit the notification button down below. It'd be greatly appreciated. So that way you will know when I come on board and everything with new videos. And the more likes I get, the more I will be recommended. Also, check me out at patreon.com/bwroses. Support me there with a $1, $3 tier. Also, check me out at, you know, check me out at divinart.com/bbw1979. Also, find me at BW Roses Discussions, all your favorite audio podcast locations except for Pandora, where you will find audio versions of some of the YouTube videos you get here, live streams as well, and eventually you will get this one as well. In that case, you can find me at divinart.com/bbw1979. Also, at BW Roses Discussions, all your favorite audio podcast platforms except for Pandora. Also, check me out at Vimeo at BW Roses for content you can't get here on YouTube. As well as support me at Venmo at Brian-Walmer-2. Guys, I can use the financial help right now because one of the topics I'm going to talk about to start this off with does kind of concern finances and everything. So, again, check me out at BW. So, support me at Venmo at Brian-Walmer-2. And a Cash App at BWRoses98. Again, guys, it'd be greatly appreciated if you can help support me financially there. That way, I get the money automatically and it will go right into my account, whatever you guys can do. Also, Super Chats, Super Stickers will be open during the live chat of the premiere, and Super Thanks afterwards as well. So, with that all out of the way, let's get into our topic, shall we, for today, this on-location version of Topics on My Mind. I do apologize for a lot of the pausing, a lot of the windy breeze. It is windy today. You know, it's definitely fall now. You can feel that. And, of course, like I say, I apologize for a lot of the moving around and pausing. That's the one tricky part about when you do things, you know, recordings online and at home. What I'm trying to say is, let me rewind there. All right. Basically, what I was trying to say, because again, this is the tricky part. This is what happens when you do these kind of recordings on location instead of at home, because you got to watch where, you know, where people are, you know, how they view you, and also the fact that if you're doing it before or after work, you got to work around certain situations where your job is going to have a lot to do. Well, you know, you're trying to bide your time, if you know what I mean, before clocking in. But with that said, though, guys, let's get into our first topic of the day. And our first topic for today, again, deals with something that relates to me asking you to support me with Venmo and Cash App at Brian-Woman-2 for Venmo and Cash App at BW Roses. And that is, of course, this gas rebate stimulus that we got going here in California. And I'm sure you guys have had something similar in other states as well. But it feels kind of confusing, you know? It feels kind of confusing and stuff because it's almost like, you know, it's almost like it doesn't matter what state does this. If you kind of see what I'm saying, it doesn't matter what state does this and all that. It just seems a little, you know, a little weird and everything. That, you know, it's great that they tell you that they're going to do it to make up for the rising prices of gas and all that, and that's nice to hear and everything, that's fine to hear and everything, but still, it's like, well, you know, if you guys are doing that, you know, give us at least an idea as to when a lot of us are going to receive our payments, you know, not just, you know, through, you know, checks, you know, paper checks and everything that you mail or debit cards and all that. You know, let us know, like, for those of us that have direct deposit, let us know when we're going to expect a direct deposit. Don't just say, oh, it's going to start the 7th, and the first round's going to go to the 24th, 25th, and then the next round's going to start between the 25th and the 28th, and run till the 14th. You know, don't just say that and expect us to, you know, just go with it. No. Tell us something. You know, tell us something that is going to basically, you know, let us in on, you know, when to expect them, like what date, if you will, you know, what dates and everything, if you will, to expect them to show up in our direct deposits. You know, don't expect us to, just guesstimate and all that as to when, because that doesn't help us. You know, that doesn't help us, you know, whatsoever. You know, it doesn't help us, you know, in the slightest, just to guesstimate and wonder day by day, hour by hour, minute by minute, when is it going to show up? Because there's a lot of us that depend on that money, you know, even if it's not much, depending on our status, whether we're single, whether we filed individually, whether we filed because instead we had a dependent, whether we filed jointly or whatever. There's some of us that depend on that money, or depend on that money, you know, and, you know, when it shows up. We don't expect, you know, we don't expect the government to play games with us, in a way. We don't expect our state government or our federal government to play games with us, you know, without, you know, letting us, they probably use direct deposit, you know, when we're going to get that money in our accounts, because it's not fair. It is not. I mean, I'll give you an honest truth, and I do apologize for the wind here. I'll give you an honest truth. You know, recently my mom, you know, had to pay for cable this month. And even though the cable's under her name, our agreement is I'm the one that pays it, because it's mainly something that, you know, I will utilize to maybe order an AEW pay-per-view or something that I might like on pay-per-view. You know, it's my responsibility, because I'm also the one that adds the channels. You know, if I want to add a channel, or she suggests, you know, probably adding a channel in the future, and I do it, or I add a package, or whatever, or I increase the internet to a faster, you know, speed and stuff, or I change the phone service, or I upgrade the DVR to unlimited. You know, basically that's all on me. it's all on me, even though it's under her name, it's all on me. So, so for me, I was hoping for that money to show up so I could use that to pay a majority of the cable, if not all of it, to make it current. I don't like the idea that I have to have my mom do it, because that's another burden she doesn't need. You know, even though financially, she has the money, and that's all I'm going to say, it's another burden she doesn't need, because she has plans. She has these goals in mind that I want to help her see, become reality, become true. I don't expect her to have to, deviate from that direction. So to me, whether it's California you live in, whether it's New York, whether it's the Midwest or whatever, if your state is doing something like this to kind of rectify the high rise of gas prices and stuff, in your state, then they should at least give you an idea as to when and where it's going to show up, not just from a debit card perspective or a mail you out a check perspective, no, but also a direct deposit perspective. Let you know when they're going to do it, when you can expect it. Heck, even let you know how they, decide when one gets out. Do they do it by, by the last four numbers of your Social Security? Do they do it by, your tax ID, when you filed, do they do it by your last name? What do they do it by? Like I said, like I asked, what do they do about it? Give us some kind of clue. Give us some kind of an idea. So that way we could be, better prepared. So we could be like, okay, I need to hold off till this time frame, because this is when it's going to go in. Don't just say, oh, we're going to send them out at this time, and just randomly expect us to check every day, every hour, every minute, because that's not fair. That's not right. Because what it really sounds like to me, Honestly, what it really sounds like and looks like to me is, despite the fact that they've made this promise and the following through with it, it's almost like they don't want to give that money out. It's almost like they are reluctant to do it, which is why they don't, do it the right way. They don't play fair by it and let people know, this is when you're going to get it from a direct deposit perspective, so you can expect it then, so you can check then. It's not fair. It's not fair to us. It's not fair to us as citizens, in the long run. And in a way, it's kind of not fair to them, because it makes them look bad. Like, you want us to trust you? Then prove it. Prove we can trust you by doing the right thing. Going out there and telling people, just like you're doing with the debit cards and the paper checks and everything, go out there and tell the people, this is when you can expect your direct deposit to be in your bank. This is when, or at least let them know, this is how we're doing it. So, go by that, and that'll help. Whether it's by Social Security number, tax number, or, your last name, give us something. Because the more you make us randomly think and wait, okay, when is it coming, the more we're going to become suspicious of you. That's the entire thing. The more we're going to become suspicious of you, and the fact that you may not really want to put out the resources to make this happen. Like, you are reluctant to do it. So, if I'm any state government that's doing something similar to what we're doing here in California, our government's doing, do us a favor, get your act together. Get your act together and be honest with your people, okay? I mean, only recently did I find out through the news, the various sites, that basically, anybody that got the first Golden State stimulus, we got the second one, but anybody that got the first Golden State stimulus, were the ones that got the checks first. And it would have been nice to know that at the beginning. That would have been nice to know that those that got the GSS, they call it, you know, were going to get the checks first between the 7th and the 24th. It would have been nice to know that so that we wouldn't be so expecting of it. And this is, again, something that needs to change. You know, they need to not put the details in there almost afterwards, you know, because a lot of people are going to expect almost like on the first day or so, something like, you know, something like these checks to make an appearance. So, again, to any state government that's doing this, get your act together. Get your act together and give people a true idea as to when, from a direct deposit perspective, when they can expect their checks. Because if you don't, again, that trust you want is going to waver even further away, and it's going to make it look like you don't want to give out that money, period. All right, on to our next topic, and hopefully you'll be able to hear me a little bit better with less wind, because I got the buildings in between me, and hopefully there'll be no interruption. But on to the next topic here, let's kind of brighten the news a little bit and talk about My Little Pony Generation 5. That's right, let's talk about MLPG 5 and the fact that on the Netflix YouTube page, and I'm guessing the official MLP page, they do have up images and stuff, or trailers, you know, clips if you will, for the upcoming winter holiday, basically the Christmas special, coming out next month. So yeah, they have that up now. And it looks actually pretty good from what I've seen. I haven't seen the trailer yet or the clip yet, but I will say again, it looks good. The animation looks all right. Looks like it's on par to not with just the series, but kind of like with the movie a little bit. So we'll see what happens there. And it definitely looks like it's gonna focus around Pip and Zip mostly, just from what the screenshots are showing. So it looks like it's gonna, you know, focus on them. But, you know, we'll see. Again, I haven't seen the clips yet, and I don't think they put out a trailer yet as far as I know. But it definitely looks like a majority of the story is going to focus on Pip and Zip throughout. Because you see them doing like another portrait day picture, maybe a holiday picture with the mom, Queen Haven. And when they show back up at home, I should say. So that's going to be something to look forward to, something to kind of keep an eye on as, you know, you watch the special and more clues come out, you know, for this story that premieres in the next several weeks on Netflix. But, yeah, you know, like I said, the animation from the screen caps looks good. I thoroughly enjoy what I'm seeing. Again, it feels like part of it's going to focus on Zip and Pip. You know, like they're going to have an arc. It almost feels like it might take inspiration from Best Gift Ever, where each of the main six or main seven had an arc, if you will, when it came to trying to find the best gift for the heart, you know, for the pony that was the heartwarming helper. You know, like Twilight had an arc for her gift to get Pinky for Twilight, you know, Spike eventually for Rarity for Applejack for Spike, Fluttershy for Rainbow Dash, even though originally she had Rarity, Rainbow Dash for, along with Discord for Fluttershy, you get the idea, so basically, you know, it looks like that's going to be maybe the direction they go in the near future with the special when it premieres. Hold on. Like I said, it looks like it's going to be taking possibly inspiration from that, you know, for the special. I could be wrong, but we'll see. we'll see in the near future, very near future, when it premieres, and we get more information as it approaches to its debut on Netflix. But I like it. I like the idea we're getting a Christmas special, basically a holiday special, from MLPG5 to kind of like show that it's not just going to be all of Make Your Mark, you know, that they're also going to kind of take a break and, you know, go and do their own individual specials and everything based on holidays and all that. Now, whether or not this is based, well, not based, but whether or not this takes place within the context of Make Your Mark, you know, kind of a continuity standpoint, we'll have to see. I mean, Best Gift Ever was in the continuity of, was basically set in the main continuity and everything. You kind of saw reflections of that in the final season, especially if you're a Spike and Rarity fan with Dragon Drop and so on. But still, you know, you saw some reflections of it, not much. You know, you saw some reflections of it, you know, not much. But we'll see what they do. We'll see what they have in mind as, you know, we get closer to its, you know, debut and everything, and whether or not it does tie in with the current continuity of Make Your Mark or it's its own individual thing. So we'll have to see. I mean, it could be like Rainbow Road Trip, where it is, you know, just its own individual thing. Like, maybe it is alluded to, but not really. And it's kind of its own self-contained story. But we'll see. We'll see what they have planned and just go from there. But I've got a feeling it's going to be good. Yes, it's probably going to have some songs, there's no doubt. But I'm looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to maybe seeing what is, you know, probably revealed in there. Like, maybe we'll find out that might have a crush on Hitch. We don't know. We'll see. We'll see what happens. But, yeah, you know, that's coming out. Again, the screen grabs, the, you know, the screenshots, if you will, for the preview. I haven't seen the clips, the video clip yet, the video preview of it yet. But they look pretty good. They look on par to what we're seeing in the series right now, if not a little bit with the movie. So we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens. But yeah, that's all I'm going to say on it. And now on to the next topic. So staying with Netflix, we're going to talk about basically Sonic Prime. And apparently tomorrow, Netflix, via the Twitch channel, is going to have an event where they preview a lot of the shows they currently have on, as well as some of the current shows they have coming up real soon, and Sonic Prime is going to be one of them. It's going to be one of the main focuses of that preview, and it's going to be hosted by, I can't think of her name right now, Christina, a K that starts with a K, it's a Christina or something, can't think of her name right now, but it's going to involve Sonic Prime, you know, the preview. It's going to, like I say, give us more of an idea of, you know, what to expect, most definitely probably give us more of a look, like a trailer, an actual trailer, as to what's going to be in store and who's going to be involved, you know. And I think that's great. I think it's great that they're doing that. And I can't wait to see, you know, what that trailer is going to be like, what more information we get. I mean, we know that basically it's a multiverse story arc they're going to be doing with it, but we don't know how far they're going to go with this multiverse deal. I mean, there are hints to Satayam, but will they do Satayam? You know, that's one thing, you know, that's being questioned. Will they do Satayam? And, you know, there are people that work on the series that are, you know, from Wildbrain that are saying, no, Satayam's not going to be involved. But we also have to remember that sometimes people say that to throw you off. You know, like they'll say, oh, this person's not going to be involved, that's not going to be involved, this is not going to happen, and then it does. Kind of like with the whole Spider-Man thing and, you know, No Way Home, I think. Was it No Way Home? Yeah, it was No Way Home. Kind of like with the Spider-Man thing there, where, you know, Tobey Maguire and Andrew Garfield were denying several times over. They were, you know, denying several times over that they weren't in the movie, and yet everybody knew, oh, you're in the movie, deny all you want, you're in the movie, we can already tell you're in the movie. And it was all thanks to like little leaks here and there, you know, of images, you know, people would take with the cameras from, you know, production sets on the streets, or someone leaked, you know, some audio and stuff. It's like pretty much the evidence was there no matter how much they tried to deny it. And and eventually when it happened, you know, they had no choice but to finally admit, okay, we made up the fact that we weren't going to be in it because we were trying to make it a surprise. So, you know, as far as, you know, that relates to Sonic Prime, you know, we'll have to see. You know, maybe we might get a glimpse of something Saturday-like in the series, in this new preview, the, you know, trailer, whatever they present to us today, when you're watching this. But we'll see. We'll see what they have planned. I mean, obviously people are expecting a lot of different incarnations of Sonic and everything. You know, what we will get is up to them. You know, what we will get will be up to them. But it's, like I said, it's going to be interesting. It's going to be fun to just, you know, speculate and everything, because the show is supposed to come out at the end of this year. So with that in mind, it's going to be fun to, just based on what we're getting here, you know, it's going to be fun to kind of see, you know, what they bring to the table and everything, as time goes on, leading up to that December release and everything. But yeah, I'm kind of happy that they were getting more information. Again, don't know exactly what kind of information it's going to be as we build towards. Hold on for a sec. Like I said, it's going to be interesting to speculate and wonder about as, you know, we build forward, as we build closer and more forward to the show's debut in December. It's going to be interesting. But yeah, it's, like I said, it's nice that we're getting more information. You know, hopefully we'll, like I said, hopefully we'll get another trailer, give us a better idea of, you know, what to expect, you know, as we get closer to that moment. So, yeah, that's all I can really say on it, and we'll see what we get today, when you watch this. So we'll see what we get today, you know, and everything, you know, as you watch this, and, you know, when you're watching this, I should say, and just go from there. You know, just go from there, if you will. But yeah, I'm kind of happy we're getting more information, and, you know, can't wait to see, you know, what's in store for us, you know, with the show, and whether or not we will get something Saturday-like, underground-like, in the future. Good that we're getting more information, and getting more information today when this debuts, which is the day the stream is supposed to happen. So we'll see what they have planned. But yeah, can't wait for it. And to close out this topic on my mind, we're going to talk about the fact that yes, this Monday will be Halloween, but then this Tuesday will be November 1st. And what that means is Halloween, of course, is looked at as the pre-start officially to the holiday season. And what that also means is November 1st, if not November 2nd, if you have a music choice channel, that means your music choice channel will start emanating, you know, a lot of Christmas music, and you'll start hearing Christmas music also on your radio stations and stuff a lot more, as well as even the radio networks of your jobs and stuff. So you'll be hearing that, a lot of that, real soon. But what's crazy is not just the fact that, of course, a lot of stores are already selling Christmas items, my store here included, if you will, my store here included is doing that, but the fact that you're already getting countdowns to Christmas specials, holiday specials, going into next month. Like, already they're letting you know about Rudolph and Frosty coming out in November. Like they said, and Frosty's coming out the day, you know, Thanksgiving weekend, basically. Thanksgiving Friday. It'll be on CBS. And then several days later, CBS is going to do Rudolph. So, They're already letting you know when this is coming out. They've already let you know that A Charlie Brown Christmas is going to be on PBS only once this year, which will be December 19th. So they're already getting things, you know, slotted in there for you guys, for us, I should say, to look forward to DVR and everything for the Christmas season. And I can't wait. I cannot wait for a lot of this, because basically what's crazy about, you know, the holiday season is once Halloween passes, that's when, for some odd reason, the holiday season really, like I say, the pre-start of it kicks into high gear. And not only does it kick into high gear, but basically, long story short, it kind of helps the rest of the year to go by faster. It helps the rest of the year to go by faster. It helps the rest of the year go by faster, if you will, and helps us get quicker to the helps us get quicker to the new year of 2023. So it definitely helps things go by faster, you know, as time moves on, and that's kind of great to know. It's kind of great to look forward to and everything, you know, as we move along, so I like it. I like the fact that, you know, when we get to that time of year here after Halloween, that's when things start to really you know, they start to really percolate a lot faster when it comes to the holiday season. It really does. Again, you know, things just go faster. Yeah, the holidays, for some reason, go a little longer. Like, the actual holidays themselves go a little longer. But that's to be expected. That's to be expected. But I'm looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to it in a major way. Really? Hold on. Sorry about that, but like I said, I'm really looking forward to it, you know. I mean, when, I don't know what it is, but when you get to like this time of year, and even before Halloween, not only do you see the stuff coming out and all that, but you start hearing information come out about Christmas specials and stuff like that. It really starts to make you, you know, realize, hey, you are that close. You are closer than you can expect. So I'm looking forward to it. You know, I'm really looking forward to it in the next several months, in the next 2 months, you know, because again, it seems that things do go a little faster, but they also do tend to slow down a little bit to help you appreciate more of what's going on. I could definitely tell you, go to the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade website, and they're already pretty much telling you what to expect for the parade within the next month, which is basically literally about a month from now, you know, itself. Because they're already telling you what to expect and be ready for, you know, when that event happens. And the one good thing about my job is this year I will be off. I don't know about Black Friday, but I will be off for Thanksgiving this year. So I'll be able to record the parade, DVR it and record it when it comes on. But anyway, yeah, it's hard to believe that you're already getting, you know, pretty much dates confirmed for the holiday specials, the Christmas specials and stuff, the new ones, classic ones and all that. I mean, heck, we're getting a freaking Backstreet Boy Christmas. How about that? I think it's a concert musical thing going, so we got that happening. You know, yeah, it's great to know. It's great to know. It's great to see. And you know, can't wait, you know, can't wait for that day to, you know, for these specials and stuff to air and really start to help get us in the, you know, holiday mood and everything, you know, as time goes on, and we finish out 2022 and go into 2023. So, yeah, that's all I can really say on that, guys. honestly. That's really all I can say on it. But that's going to pretty much do it for this unusual on-location topics on my mind. I do apologize for any wind and everything, but thank you for watching. And until next time, guys, I will talk to you all later. Again, as I mentioned at the beginning, you can support me at patreon.com. So that's BWRoses, $1, $3 tier. Venmo at Brian-Womer-2, Cash App at BWRoses98. Vimo at BWRoses, so content you can't get here on YouTube. DeviantArt.com, so that's BVW1979. You can also find me at BWRoses Discussion, sorry for audio podcast platforms except Pandora, as well as check out my Teespring store as well. So again, guys, thank you all for joining me for this unusual, topics on my mind on location for my job. That's about, 30 minutes away from clocking in. And until next time, guys, I will talk to you all later.